Hey everybody, and welcome to a very special reality recaps at BB Canada special show with Raul. You guys know the deal. You can check out all of our previous shows at yourrealityrecaps.com/BBCan if you missed any of the previous house guest interviews or BB jury shows. To let you guys know quickly, this Sunday we have Nick and Phil, Monday Cassandra, and Tuesday will be Mitch. If you guys are watching this back on YouTube later, you can click on these buttons, thumbs up and subscribe, iTunes, 5-star rating, and a nice review. And lastly, become a patron, yourrealityrecaps.com/patron if you want to help support our shows and everything that we do and continue to bring you all this amazing coverage for Big Brother Canada. Become a patron. You get some pretty cool stuff. But without further ado, and our reality recaps first, live from the backseat of a car, accompanied by Dana, it's Raul is here. Hi, Raul.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good, thanks. I'm excited to do this. It's so much fun.
Raul, this is a first for us. Live from a car.
Yeah. So weird.
Where are you on your way to, Raul?
Well, I'm on my way to CB Onsen in Edmonton. I'm so excited and I can just wait to party.
Well, you were doing a little partying in Niagara Falls, Raul, we saw. How was that?
It was crazy, crazy. It was an amazing experience. I got to see everybody from other seasons, and they love me, thank God. But it was awesome, yeah.
And how are you doing tonight, Dana?
I'm fantastic. I'm with Raul. How can I not... I'm not with Raul, but... I wish I was with Raul going to Beyonce.
I was going to say, are you two a couple now? chat room.
Well, you know, we spent some time in the bathroom together.
That is true. Chat room, you guys know the deal. If you have questions for Raul, you can put them in the chat room or you can tweet us them with hashtag YRRLive. But Raul, I have a very serious question.
Yeah.
I have a problem, Raul.
What is
it? I love you. As a fellow gay, I love you, okay. Raul. I love you. Okay. I had two little problems. We got to get to the important stuff first. Then we'll ask everyone's questions. Raul.
Let's do it.
Who were you talking to?
Oh. Yes. Okay. Obviously, that was just a hi to say, like, hi, friends. Like, my two best friends.
Oh, was your
friend as well? Yeah. So I was just saying hi to them. Like, I wasn't allowed to say it on the program. Like, on the show, but now I'm like saying it.
okay, we wanted to know if it was like a secret rendezvous or a lover, but okay, it was your friends.
In my besties, yeah.
Okay, my second question, Raul, is what
up, Raul.
What happened to the bottom half of your jacket?
Which one? Oh my god.
Raul, I want to buy you a bottom. Raul, are you wearing that jacket right now? Raul, that's deal. Okay. Because that could be a deal breaker.
But it's so, I love that jacket. If Jared, I was always like, oh my God, did you buy that at Baby Gap? And I'm just like, no, like, stop. Like, it's beautiful. Like, I love it. I was like, don't care.
I loved it. I said Dana, I told Dana when we did the interviews, we were going to bring you the bottom half of a leather jacket and be like, here you go, Raul. Here's the little bottom half for you. No.
I was going to sew it on while we were interviewing.
We love you, Raul. Of course, we love you. Now, are you going to Beyonce? We saw that you're tweeting it, that you're going to Beyonce. Are you going with any other Big Brother people?
No, they're not. Well, I don't know. I hope I get to see Dallas probably, but I honestly don't know. Like, I think it's going to be two of my best friends, and I'm tired of them. Like, I just want to be with my family now and friends, you know?
Yeah.
You spent some time with Nikki, right? A couple days ago.
Yeah, I spent some time with Nikki and Kelsey yesterday, and we had so much fun partying. We went to an amazing restaurant. It was so much fun.
Have you talked to, you know, I think a number one question that we're getting from so many people is, who are you now still close with now that you've been out of the house? Like, who are you? Go ahead.
I'm like really, really close. Who I talk to like every day is Kelsey and Jared. We're still like best friends. Like, I love Jared. He's coming to visit us next week, actually. I'm so excited.
Raul, that is perfect. Guess who are the only two jury people we don't have booked yet?
Oh, really?
Jared and Kelsey. So you have to put a good word in for us.
I will, for sure.
Okay. So are you happy with the winners? That is another question from we're getting from tons of people.
Obviously, because that meant that my alliance went to Leanne and she got second place. I love that she got second place. I wish she would have won, of course. But I don't know what to say about the brothers. I love them so much. But they did pretty good on competition, especially Nick. Like, Nick was amazing. And so they deserve it, I guess so.
Well, just saying, now that the brothers have won, you did tell me that they need the most fashion help in the house.
Oh, yes.
So hopefully they will use some of their 100K up their fashion game.
They did won, like, a wardrobe change.
Yeah,
like,
that's right. So, are you going to help them?
I'm going to help them pick underwear.
Oh, Raul, I got to thank you. Also, on behalf of the gays, Raul, right in the beginning of the season, you got those brothers to get their shirts off. You were, like, painting in abs. I was like, oh, thank you, Raul. You were, like, turning them to the camera for us. We were like, thank you, Raul. Thank you.
What was it like being in a house with all those hot boys, though, Raul? Were you just, like, dying in there?
Horrible. And believe me, everybody's so horny in there. Like, it's crazy. So you're, like, dying, and you have all these beautiful straight men. I'm just like, this sucks. Like, it's so bad. But I got to touch them every day. So.
You did. Now, let's talk about, for a second, the other gay man in the house, Mitch.
Yes.
Of course, you know, he was kind of a fan favorite. Yeah. And people were not happy that you were part of his demise, Raul.
I know.
Okay, so what do you want to say about it, Raul?
Well, you know, queens, after, like, they always come for each other, and it's just like, it just happened, I guess. It was just game-wise. I think I made a choice for the house and not for myself, which it sucks, but at the same time, like, it killed me because I loved him so much. Like, I was crying so much, and I felt, like, so bad that I did that. I was like, okay, did I sure regret this or no? But you know, sometimes it's a game, and you know, like, it changed the whole strategy that I was doing. So if you guys don't like it, well, whatever.
Now, if Mitch was single going into that house, would we have seen our first gay showmance of Big Brother Canada ever?
No.
He's not your type.
I don't know. He's totally my type. He's extremely handsome, has good booty, you know, and so smart. But there was this part where I had, like, a little crush on him. I told him I had, like, this dream about him, and, like, he went crazy. And then I was just like, oh, my goodness. Like, so I stopped talking to him for, like, 3 days. And he's like, why are you not talking to me? And I was like, I don't know. Like, I don't want to talk to you.
But you guys obviously worked it all out in jury, and you guys are super fine and close now.
Oh, yeah. We're really close to us as well. So I don't get to talk to him a lot, but I miss him so much.
Now, Raul, I don't know if you know this. Do you know that a lot of people had fun with Raul memes during the season? Oh,
I know. I came out and I saw all these memes, and I was like, oh my gosh, Rail, like, the new word of the day is Bishop. And it's just like, what is all this? It's so funny. I love it. Like, I love it. I love it.
Well, good. In that spirit, Giselle in the chat room wants to know, Raul, did you vote for Kelsey because you thought chicken wing or for sympathy?
I voted her because she was my alliance. And, like, you know, we had each other through the whole game. So it's like, obviously, I was going to give my vote. Like, I feel really so dumb if I would have given the vote to the brothers because, like, yeah, I just wanted her to win, so I have to vote her.
I think we knew that you were going to vote for her. I think people, you know, knew that you were going to vote for her, and it made sense. You three, I mean, Kelsey got to the end of this game one way or another. She made it to the end of the game. And do you feel, do you wish you would have done anything differently in the house? Go ahead.
I wish I should have, like, separated from them sooner than, you know, because, like, we were such a strong alliance. Like, people were attacking us since day one. Like, I don't even understand why. We were awesome. Like, that's why we didn't even attack anybody. But I wish I should have separated from them sooner. And, like, because I know, like, when Kelsey came back, it was going to be Jared and Kelsey again. And obviously now I became the actual third wheel. So I was like, ugh, okay, well, whatever. We'll see what happens. But I think that's the only thing I will switch if, like, if I would be there, you know?
Mm-hmm. I think that's what we were thinking. Like, were you thinking, we'll just get to the final three and then I'll just win out and take who I want? Like, because you knew they were never going to take you, unfortunately. But so you would have had to win out at the end.
Yeah. It's scary.
You wouldn't have done it, Raul. I know you would have. You are a good person. And we have, like, this problem when we're gay that, like, we want to, like, we have to do the right thing all the time. Yeah. And that's why I won't play Big Brother, because I know that I will give in to my emotions. Mm-hmm. But let me ask you this. Jomo in the chat room wants to know, Raul, you got to play with Nikki. But would you ever go on to another country's Big Brother?
Oh, I'm actually going. This is a real question, because I'm actually going to apply to Big Brother Mexico this year.
Really?
I think there's a Big Brother Mexico right now. So it's like it started to go again. So I think I'm going to apply and check it out.
Ooh.
Oh my God. Will they subtitle that so we can understand it?
I don't know. I just talk in English all the time. I'm like, oh, this is for my Canadian people.
You have to. You need to talk to us. Rafe S. wants to know, Raul, why didn't you try harder to win that veto and save yourself instead of Jared?
I know. I have no idea what happened there. Like, Instead of thinking, like, okay, like, if I can get it, I could save myself, Jared, and bring Kelsey back into the house. The thing is that it's like, at that point, I forgot. Like, I never saw me first. I saw my friendship and my, you know, my people to be safe. So I don't know why I did that, honestly. And I should have won it. Like, so Jared was like, oh, because people are saying that I threw it at him. Like, I gave him that. You know, which, let's get real, I kind of did. So now it's just like, because I was like, bro, you never give me anything. I was doing amazing. I was like, yeah, you were, but, like, I did get it to you. So,
yeah. Interesting. Yeah. Well, go ahead, Dana.
I have a very important question from the chat room. I can't remember who said it, but they want to know, if you were straight, would you date Kelsey?
Oh, my God, yes. Like, oh, my God, for sure I will. Like, we'll have amazing sex still.
She's gorgeous. She is absolutely stunning.
Oh, yeah. I love her. She's so nice. Yeah.
Okay. I would also like to remind everyone, I forgot to tell you guys at the beginning of the show, the number one fan on this show right now in the chat room is going to win Rail's autograph. Don't worry, Dana already got it from you. So the number one fan on the show is going to win Raul's autograph. Now, speaking of that, but not at all really, XOXO Feedsters just has a comment. First of, thank you for contouring and putting Jared and makeup on Snapchat in the jury house. We all loved it. And then over on Twitter, she's following up with, Raul, what's your favorite contouring products? # asking for a friend.
Oh, that's awesome. Well, thank you for you guys. I'm so happy that you guys like that. It was so funny. I'm doing Jared's makeup. My favorite makeup brand for contouring is the Anastasia Beverly Hills cream and the Kat Devon C, I think it's called, those powders. Yeah.
And they should give Raul an endorsement, so tweet them and let them know.
I hope you DVR'd the Drag Race season while you were in there.
Oh my gosh, I didn't. I'm so excited to see. I can't wait to see. I saw the already watched. I was like, damn it.
I just watched the finale. It's so good. So good, Raul.
So good. I'm so jealous.
It is. It is a very good season. Lisa MTL wants to know, Raul, you are close with Jared now. You are close with Kelsey. But a lot of us, when we were watching the show, we saw Jared kind of getting in your face in the pantry room and being very aggressive towards you. Lisa MTL wants to know, what were your thoughts when Jared was scolding you after Kelsey came back?
I was honest, like, I didn't want to freak out on him, but it felt so bad, and I was like scared, and I wanted to cry so bad. Like, I felt so bad because I did screw up the whole plan, you know, her coming back. But things happened, and I wanted to punch him, basically. Like, don't talk to me like that. Because Kelsey just watched the show, she's like, I hated it when he was screaming at you, like, I'm so mad, like, I got so angry. And I'm just like, well, yeah, but whatever, we'll see. He was like my dad on the show, kind of, sometimes, yeah. So I had to take it.
You should have played it up, Raul. You should have been like, oh, he hit me, and like threw yourself on the floor. You could have got rid of him real early.
Yeah, it was.
Should have, like, walked into his fist.
Yeah.
That's what you should have done. Could have got one out right quick.
Oh, my God.
Now, I'm sure that you know this, Raul. I see Sunny Sky in the chat room asking, did it bother you that Nikki basically gave you the nickname Rail?
No, actually, I actually love it. Like, and now everybody's like, rail everywhere. So I'm just like, oh, it's funny, and I like it. Yeah, like, nobody gave me a nickname only about her. So I was like, yes, I need one. I got it. I'm good. And, you know, the Queen Nikki gave it to me. So this bitch is blessed. Yeah.
How shocking was it to come out of the house and have everyone being like, instead of screaming Raul, we're like, rail!
It was just funny. They were like, oh, my God, we love you.
Uh-oh. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what happened. Hold on. We'll wait. We'll see if they're going to come back. We might. I don't know. Live show. Yay, everybody. I don't know why. Okay, wait, let's see. Raul's back. Dana's not back.
I think she's back. Oh, no, she's not.
No. All right, well, let's keep going with you for the moment, Raul, and we'll see. Let's go to this. What was your favorite moment in the house, Raul?
My favorite moment was walking into the house. I think that was just the best thing I ever experienced. And it's something that you cannot explain in words, because you have all these big dreams, and it finally became true, you know, and just going through there, you, like, take it all in, and just, like, wow, like, it happens, like, I'm finally here, you know, and I think this was my favorite moment.
Just sure. Getting to walk into the house and be on the show.
Yeah.
Love it. Sherry Blackberry wants to know, was eating Tim's sandwich worth it when you were on Slop?
You guys, it was the best sandwich I ever had in my life. I have never had a sandwich like that. It was a salmon sandwich, and it had cream cheese and beautiful lettuce. And, oh, my God, it was so good. So it was 100% worth it. I will never forget that.
Oh, okay. Con for Peace wants to know, is there anything that you would do different if you could? Like, if you could go and change back one aspect of your game, would you do anything different?
I think I will have to learn how to talk to people so they can work with me, because when I wanted them for, like, everybody to keep me, I was like, you are a floater, you do nothing, like, you do this, so I need to learn how to fix that. And I think I will, like, don't work with the showmans anymore.
Oh, really? So now maybe you would have kept Mitch in, and because here's what we wanted to happen. We wanted you to convince Jared to use the veto. I have a touch of a bad memory, but then not put up Mitch and put up Jared. We wanted you to backstab Jared, Raul. So we wanted you to do.
It would have been funny if I would have done that. Like, honestly, I'm pretty sure you guys would have loved it. But it's like, I love him way too much. Oh, it's so cute. Like, I play emotionally hardcore in this game.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. That's what you're right. We would have all loved it. But again, we're just watching. We don't really understand the real dynamics that are going on in that house. Yeah. Rosie P11 wants to know, was this the first time that you tried out to be on Big Brother Canada?
Hello?
Oh, do you hear us now? Are we back?
Yes, it was my first.
It was your first time.
Yeah, I just. It was my first time trying out. Because I saw Jordan from season 3 when I was applying in Vancouver. And I was like, oh, hi. He came and said hi to me. And when he held my hand, he gave me this face of like weird out look at me up and down. And I was like, okay. And then he walked away. And then I found out that the first time he saw me, he was like, this guy is going to get in the show for sure. And I was just like, oh, my God. So it's crazy. Like, that's when I noticed something like, okay, like, maybe I'll make it. You know, maybe I'm going to get in.
And you did.
Yes.
Everyone is thinking you are extremely adorable right now, Raul.
Thank you.
Raul, Dizzy Pop wants to know, who was your first target? Because, you know, we don't get to see a lot of the beginning times of the house. But, like, what was the first moment where you thought, this person's going to be a problem, I might need to go after them, and who was that person?
You know, it was Tim. Like, since he walked into the house, I told Tim, like, in the house, I was like, I know that game you're playing. Like, I know who you are. I can read you. He told me he was like, yeah, like, I'm a little scared of Raul because he was like, I'm scared of you the first time I met you. Because you have, like, this face and fierce and makeup on. And he's like, I'm not going to like this guy. Like, something's going to happen with him. But I think Tim, since the day, was like, this guy is going to make it far in this game. So me and Mitch were planning to actually get him out before I got Mitch out.
Interesting. Yeah. Go ahead, Dana.
Oh, no, I'm just listening.
Oh, okay. Great Dane mom wants to know, besides the Third Wheel Alliance, is there anybody that you would have aligned with or wish that you had aligned with now?
Well, I wish I would have aligned with, like, with Tim. Like, I wish we could have worked an alliance together. But I offered him to work with us on the Third Wheel Alliance. Like, he wouldn't take it. And I was like, okay, bro, like, I'm not asking again, so. But yeah, so I wish I could have made an alliance with him for sure. He's really smart and he played this game amazing.
He did. Angie Star wants to know, what was it like hanging out with Maddie?
Oh, like outside the house, it was amazing. I actually love Maddie and like she's so much fun. She makes me laugh so hard. She makes like these weird expressions and I'm just like, oh my God, like it's hilarious. So it was a lot of fun having her around in Toronto and everybody's just like, oh my God, Maddie, whatever. But no, she's actually such a nice and genuine person. She has a great heart. Yeah, she can be a little bitch, but like we can all be, you know. Like, but
her Snapchat is really good.
Oh, her Snapchat?
Yeah, her Snapchat game is pretty good.
I should check it out. I haven't seen it. She's really pretty. I actually love her. Like, yeah.
Redheaded Michelle wants to know, what was your most favorite or craziest moment from the jury house?
Oh my God, it was when we got to kayak, me and Mitch. It was so much fun kayaking with him. I think it was such a crazy thing too. But drinking was amazing too. Finally, we were able to drink as much as we wanted. We did got caught once because we were so much drunk that one night. But we were over and yeah.
Here's a very important question, Raul, and I think about this really, really hard. How small was Tim's wee-wee when he streaked in the bathroom? Maximus mom needs to know. Eric's looking like this is my question. I'm like, no.
I don't know if you should answer that. But you know, she's drawing the door.
It's from Australia. G'day, mate. I see a lot of people asking this question. I think Con for Peace asked it. I think I saw Maximus' mom asked it. Here it is over on Twitter from XOXO Feedsters, who, you know, tweeted so much stuff about Big Brother Canada and is hysterical. You should totally go and check out her tweets. But she wants to know, Raul, how was your night of howling and podcasting from solitary in the backyard? And do you always go around and just howl all the time?
No, actually. I was so bored. So I had to, like, howl. Because if I did that, then the guys from the inside, and like, inside the house will do it. And they start doing it. But then Phil got so mad. He was like, can somebody tell him to shut up or whatever? And then Kelsey was like, oh, you should stop. Like, it's alone. But it was nice to be alone. But the thing is, I started tweeting pictures in the house and started drinking. And I'm just there, like, outside listening to them party. And I was like, ah, oh, this sucks. Like, I wish I could be there. But, you know, the sandwich was worth it. So I don't care.
The sandwich was worth it.
Yeah.
Angel Chick 845 wants to know, Raul, what was your favorite competition you played in this season?
My favorite competition thing, I think it was the mouse one. The mm-hmm. mouse and the cowboys. They were so being a cowboy was so much. Just I hated that hat, by the way. But Big Brother kills me all the time. But the mouse, the six blind mice, and the cowboys. I don't remember the name of that one, but they were so much fun. And Jared looked so hot as a cowboy. So I was like, yeah, I'm from here. Let's do it.
Okay, Raul, quickly, since we see you and hear you perfectly right now, I got a question for you. Or I got to let you know something. Nikki did a whole Raul impression.
I know.
So would you like to get her back and do a Nikki impression? Give us your best Nikki.
Because maybe that one is like...
Troll Nikki.
It's like going crazy. And I was like, oh my God, stop doing that.
I would have went chocolate, vodka. I'm a chocolate. Chocolate and vodka.
I need to drink vodka to have fun. Yeah.
Which children out there, no, you do not.
So who were you most surprised to see and show up at the jury house?
Joel. Oh my goodness. I like pissed my pants when I saw him. I was like, holy cow, dude, what are you doing here? Like, he was the perfect person to tell to the end. Like, you could... Well, I'm sorry, Joel, if you're watching, honey. But I was actually extremely surprised when he walked in there. Like,
have you watched any of the Big Brother back?
No, I don't want to. I'm scared. Cause I'm like,
or at least watch the last, like, 5 weeks, because it'll totally make sense when you see how Cassandra manipulated everybody in the house, how Joel ended up walking. Like, if you just even want to pick up where you... left, so you don't have to watch yourself, because I know I wouldn't be able to watch myself either.
Yeah,
but just
weird.
watching Cassandra navigate through that house, you'll be like, wow.
Yeah.
You know what else you could do, Raul? This is a way that some people do it and they enjoy it if they're afraid of like how they're gonna feel or they don't want to get upset. They watch it backwards. So in other words, kind of start at the end in like where you've been evicted, but then you end up where you're all coming in the house and you kind of walk away from it not feeling so sad.
That's such a good idea. Like, when I cry now. That's such a good idea. I'm sorry using that then. Good idea.
You're welcome. You can pay me back by getting Jared and Kelsey on the show next week.
Okay.
And Maddie.
Oh, yeah, and Maddie, whatever. Right. Giselle wants to know, Raul, what would have been in your HOH basket? A lot of people actually asked this question.
What was it? Like,
what would have been, like, if you could have picked stuff for your HOH basket?
Well, obviously tequila again, for sure. Like, that's number one. There will be, question. I think there will be my cell phone, an iPod. Yeah, and then some good old men.
No, okay.
Just a guy is sitting there in my basket.
From RuPaul's Drag Race.
Yeah.
I would like to be the person who has to collect your sheet of what you fill out. Like, the DR people are going to be like, hey, he wants men, tequila. Yeah. Raul, they're going to be like, Raul, please come back to the diary room. You need to redo your questionnaire. Do you want any chips? Is there any chips we can get you, Raul?
Chocolate.
Yeah, chocolate? I don't know. Are you a fan of Survivor? Do you, like, watch Survivor at all?
Not really. I never watched it. I'm not a big fan of it. I could never leave outside. I'm like, the hell with that. I will never be that dirty. No, thank you.
No.
I'm with you, honey. I'm with you.
Same.
Yeah, I think it is fun, though. I've seen some episodes, and I do like it. I just need to catch up with it. Like, Mitch is obsessed with it. Like, he's... Well said. But yeah. I don't know. I should check it out.
Well, here's why I'm asking. On Survivor, we just had the finale a few days ago. They got to do a cool twist where one of the jurors got to be removed from the game. Like, if you, let's say you were in the final two, let's say you switch spots with Kelsey.
Okay.
Who would you have removed from the jury?
Cassandra. Bye, bitch. Bye.
You don't even have to think about it. Follow-up.
You had that ready.
Follow-up question. Raul, how are things going with you and Cassandra?
I don't know. We don't talk that much. She came into jury. We didn't talk at all. Like, I haven't talked to her. Like, we have fun on Niagara, and we hugged, and I kissed her, and it's like, you know. But we don't talk. Like, I don't know. We'll see what happens. I don't know if we will keep becoming friends. Like,
I have a prediction. I have a prediction, yes. Raul. By Christmas, you all are going to be fast friends. It all seems so personal now. You guys just got out of the house. As time goes on, I promise, I see it every season. I guarantee you will all be having Thanksgiving dinner together and in a Santa swap gift thing.
Well, I hope that it becomes true. For sure it will, I'm guessing. Like, I'm pretty sure we could be great friends. Like, we're really catty, which I love. Like, and she knows how to party. I love to party. So,
Hopefully in the friends. Rockstay wants to know, do you feel like you guys as a jury were a bitter jury? Or do you feel like there was any bitter jury members? Or do you feel like you guys, you know, chose the winner based on however you did it?
I think there were some bitters in the jury for sure. Some people, like, they did vote because of, like, some of the answers that Kelsey gave, and, you know, because the whole jury wanted to hear Kelsey being like, I used, you know, Raul and Jared to go to the end, and I kicked these people out, and I killed Tima, and whatever, which I wanted her, because if she would have said that, I'm pretty sure, what's her name, Mitch would have given her a vote, like, Tim would have given her a vote, you know what I mean? So I wish it would have been like that, but most of the people played the game of, like, okay, like, they strategize, they see why they should win it and things like that. I was like, no, girl, I'm going for my girl. Like, you know, like, yeah.
Because we tell people all the time, if you make it to the end of the game, you need to own it. You need to own it to a jury. You don't need to manipulate them anymore. Just, oh, be like, played you all.
Yeah, literally. That's, I think, I would have done that. I was like, bye, bye, bye. Like, now give me your vote.
And then if it's like Survivor, you won't win. And that was a Travis, whatever. I can't wait. Oh, whatever. Once you were in jury, Redhead Michelle wants to know, did you think that you would make it to the final? Who did you think would make it to the final two?
Oh, Tim. Tim was one of the persons that I knew he was going to be in for sure. And maybe Joel. Tim and Joel. Probably. I always thought they were going to be in.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you like? Go ahead.
So because Tim said that he will take Joel. You know, he's like, I'll take Joel to the end because I like personal things, blah blah blah. So that's why all of us thought that he was going to be them too.
I love how Bruno's thumb in the chat room is like, is Raul driving and doing the show? Yes. Don't you know old people that face sideways when they drive?
That's how they do it in Alberta. They face sideways.
Yeah, literally.
It's
they're a little weird over there.
It's Canada, Bruno's thumb. It's not like France. I don't know how they drive in France. Who Lisa MLT wants to know, who do you think played the best game besides yourself, Raul?
Oh, let's get real. Tim, Tim did amazing, honestly. Like, if he was next to, like, if none of the Turbo Alliance was up there, like, I was going to vote for Tim to win. Like, he surprises me. Like, he plays everybody so good. Like, he always, like, knows how to manipulate people. Like, he tells people what they want to hear, and people are always eating it, like, cake. Like, they're like, okay, perfect, yeah. So he's for sure playing an amazing game, and that's why I want to watch the show too, because I want to see how he, like, from the outside world, you know, perspective. But it's like, I'm excited, you know.
Well, I think this might answer that question, but Carib1985 wants to know, Raul, if it was Tim versus the brothers, Who would you have given the win to?
I think I would have given it to him, to Tim, because he deserved it. Like, heads down to him. Like, pretty good job. Yeah.
If it was Kelsey versus Tequila, who were you giving it to?
Tequila. Put it in my mouth.
Exactly. Are you going to watch?
Nikki wouldn't evict Mitch over vodka, and you're picking Tequila over your girl? Oh my God. That's savage, Raul. That is savage.
She might buy you some tequila if she won, Raul. I'm just saying. What was your favorite twist this season? A lot of people wanted to know what twist from this season, or I'll even say any other seasons. Is there like a favorite twist of Big Brother that you liked?
I think bringing the wild cards, like, that's amazing. That tells so much about, you know, Big Brother Canada, because us as Canadians, like, we're so welcoming, and we're like always bringing new people all over the world, and just having them here is like saying we are Canadians. This is what we do. We have people from all over the world, and we love it. And I think that was just such an amazing thing to do. I find it amazing. I was so mad when they came in, but I was like, now I'm like, I love it. It's amazing.
kind of on this international theme, Rowan, one of my favorite moments of this season was you and Ramsey praying together. Like, I loved watching that happen. And so, like, what did that mean to you? And how did that even, like, come about?
It was just, I asked him, because I'm always so curious about, like, I'm an explorer. I always like to try new things, new things, blah, blah. And then I find, like, the Muslim culture, well, it's not, sorry if I'm saying that wrong, but they have such an amazing, like, really, like, praying, and how they're, like, it's not called their Bible, but I forgot what they have, but.
Quran?
Quran, yes, thank you. And it's just so interesting. I love reading things like that. So when I saw Ramsey, I was like, oh my God, can you teach me how to pray? Like, I want to know how you guys do it, and like, how does it feel? And you guys, on my heart, it felt something that I, like, because I'm a really religious person. So having that moment with him, it was just so amazing, and learning new things and new cultures. It was just so crazy to me. And like, that's why I cried so much, like, after that, because it was just such an amazing experience. Yeah.
Oh no! Well, you're gonna make me cry.
I'm gonna be professional and not cry. I loved it. I was definitely emotional watching it. We would never see that on our Big Brother. Like, here in the States, they would never. I shouldn't say never, but I would be surprised if nowadays they would show that. I know back in the day they did, but yeah, I thought it was very refreshing to see the human element. Now, Giselle has another very good question. I will say, Giselle actually texted me a picture of you earlier, Raul, of you, and she asked me a question. She doesn't know I'm going to do this. She sent me this photo from Twitter.
Yes.
And she would like to, she would just like to let you know that if you're going through TSA, aside from your nose ring setting off the metal detector, are there any other things, Pierce, that might set it off?
Maybe my waist trainer.
Your waist trainer?
Yes.
What's a waist trainer?
Well, it's just that it gives you, like, a silhouette.
Oh, you mean, we call them Spanx here.
Yeah, it's like one of them.
Oh, I wear Spanx all the time. half wearing it right now. Now, Raul, did you know that they make boy Spanx?
I know. No, they're becoming such a big thing right now. And I'm guess, especially, like, muscular people use them because they make them look bigger. And I love it. And it's such a good idea.
I only have the girl Spanx, which has, like, the girl vagina slit in the bottom. And that's very hard to go to the bathroom in. That is very hard. You have to, like, bend your penis. Like,
I'm just saying,
I don't know how girls do it. Anyway, I'm just saying, I'm so glad they make boy ones. Raul, are you planning on pursuing a YouTube career? Miss Man Cougar wants to know in the chat room.
Yes, I am totally going to try and see, you know, work with YouTube and see what can I do with that. Because Mitch always told me, he's like, you should make a YouTube channel. Like, do it. Like, you could be really good at it. And I hope I'm pretty. So, but
now,
I don't know.
I don't know about YouTube. It's like a never-ending battle, and Mitch is at the top of that game. YouTube is... You got to pay a lot of money nowadays to get views on YouTube. But here's what I really do think, Raul. What we're broadcasting on right now, you don't have to do anything. You just, like, get your phone, press a button, boom, you're live. Cool. There's an instant chat room. You get to interact with fans and do anything you want. And it also streams to YouTube automatically.
Oh, wow. Okay, then, girl, you're teaching me new things up in here. I love it.
If you, I'll tell you about it after. If you really want to come on, we can totally get you set up on you now. That authority I have.
Awesome.
Oh, people love your smile. I'm getting tons of everybody loves when Raul smiles, love when Raul laughs.
Stop covering your mouth. Let us see the smile.
No, they love your smile. They want you to stop covering it. Social Mari says, Kelsey said that you slept a lot. Do you think that's true?
Yeah, I did. But then people that will never let me, they'll be like, bro, please stop napping. Or like, it's so annoying. One time they did it like 45 times in like an hour. I was so mad at it. I think they're just doing it to like make me so mad. I was like, stop telling me how to do it. And I'm just like, but I did sleep a lot. Like, I love sleeping.
What else are you guys going to do?
Yeah.
I love this question. Angel Chick is asking it. If you were asked to play Big Brother US, so like our Big Brother, but you were going to have to play as a pair, so kind of the way the brothers did, would you do it? And who would you bring as your other half?
I think I'll bring Mitch with me and play with Mitch. Because Mitch is like, he will be the brains. He will like be so good at, you know, like doing all these things, and I could do competitions, and like I can, well, I don't know if I can win them, but it's like pretty good at, but I think me and Mitch could do pretty well together in the USA. That'll be awesome. Oh my god, you guys should bring us.
I love that idea. I love that pairing, Raul. If BB Fan asked you to do All Stars, would you give Marsha a makeover?
Marsha the Moose.
No, I love Marsha. Marsha the Moose is awesome. I'm so angry that I didn't get to meet her, but I will never give her my girlfriend. That girl is going crazy up in there. Like, she reminds me of like Gary sometimes too. So I kind of like that style. So I'm gonna keep it like that.
I do. That. Are you gonna watch our Big Brother? Are you gonna watch the U.S.
Now
Big
Brother? Oh yeah, now I'm going to watch. I'm so excited. Now that I got to meet so many of you guys, it's amazing. So I'm so excited to start watching it.
Well, let me tell you this. And so far, I think LaVita is coming, and I think she's might be picking up Joel, maybe. But you should come to the New York City premiere party for Big Brother. It's like there are going to be all the Big Brother players there.
Yeah, they actually
just sent me an invitation.
Oh my god, they just sent me an invitation. I'm thinking actually to come. It'll be so much fun.
We'll be there, Raul. We'll be on the red carpet.
Oh, I love red carpets, and I'm good. I'm coming.
It's right by. If you need a place to stay, we have a house. And I'll be there this time. We already asked that question. Was all the downtime very hard on you to deal with, Raul?
Yeah, it was a little hard because I'm always a person that needs to go out and do something and, you know, talk to friends. And so for me, it was just like, oh my God, this is so boring. Like, you never think it was going to be like that. But it was a little hard, especially because if I get bored, I'll be on my phone, you know, or like be doing something. And there is like, there's not much to do. So that's why I always play joke on people, because I just couldn't handle myself.
What was it like to not be able to go outside all the time? Like,
oh, it was so annoying because you really needed that time of like fresh air or something like that. And it's like, no, you're just locking on. It's like so hot in the house. You guys have no idea. That house.
Oh, I know. I was in there. Dying in the bathroom.
Yeah, that was nothing. Like, I'm not kidding you. That was T3 chicken up in there. Like, it was so bad.
I see XOXO Feedsters asked this. I think Giselle asked it. Who is your favorite BBUS player now that you got to meet some of them? I'll start there.
Oh my god, I'm so bad with names. I keep forgetting the name, but it's like Jordan, I think, is the most.
Amanda? Did you say
Amanda? No, the little
No, Amanda? No, no, no.
No. What's his name? Oh my god, I'm so.
Oh, it's a boy. This is a fun game. I like this game.
He's like tiny, really
Jason.
Skinny. Jason. Oh my god, I love Jason.
Okay, we
agree. I'm obsessed with him.
We agree. Well then, actually, Raul, then maybe what we need to do is, hold on, where is it? No, of course it's going to be the last one. Maybe we need to send you one of Jason's shirts that say, hooker please.
Hooker, please. Oh my god, I love it. I need that. I mean, I told Jason to give me one. Jason, girl, hook me up if you're seeing, watching.
No, we will maybe. Raul, you come to the New York City premiere party.
Okay.
We will bring you a Hooker, Please Jason shirt.
Promise. Okay.
It's right here.
I need to come. Yeah, it's right here.
It's right here. We'll do it. Okay, and do you have a favorite Big Brother player from anywhere, from Canada or other countries, or just in general have a favorite Big Brother player?
My, I think it's Emmett.
Exactly. I was like, you're saying that because he's hot. That's exactly what I said when Dana was like, you should watch this.
You understand, Raul, we did a draft pick before the season started, and basically all he did was pick hot boys.
Oh, really?
And the brothers were one of them, so he won the draft.
Brother.
you made his team.
You were on my team, Raul, and I called it Team Hot, and it was all the hot people from the show.
Oh, thank you.
Mm-hmm. So we did good. We did good on our Team Hot. People said follow-up about your YouTube channel. Do you have any ideas on what you would do on the channel, like or what they could expect?
Maybe I think they're going to expect, like my fashion lab and what I do, like, as a job, and, like, all the fashion shows that I go to at these events and what I wear. So it's kind of like a vlog style, but at the same time, I do want to, like, have a lot of communication with, you know, you guys are people that watch, and I want to just answer so many questions for you. So yeah, it's just gonna be that. Maybe even a reality YouTube channel. We'll love it. Just with a camera following me, like, hey babe, you know.
I think I am going to 100% set you up with you now. It sounds exactly like what you want. It can do it as a vlog, and you're gonna have a chat room people to talk to and be live. We're gonna do that. Oh my god, so many people also are asking about this wrestling with Kelsey.
Yeah.
Do you have fun wrestling with Kelsey? We think she took advantage of you. We saw some hands go in awkward places.
Yeah, I kind of did too, because do you guys get to see the fight when she wanted a sheet from me so she can sleep on it with Mitch? You guys saw that fight? That fight got intense. Like, I literally put my two thumbs on her eyes and, like, sink them in, and it was so so intense, but it was so much fun. And yeah, she did kind of, like, touch me some place where she should have. I kind of liked it.
That's why you want to date her now.
It was the most action you got in that Big Brother house, wasn't it?
It was the most action I got, yeah.
Raul, I don't know if you can answer for them, but the Kelsey and Jared fans want to know, what's the status of their relationship since you're still friends with them? Are they gonna continue outside the house?
I don't know, but they're really good friends right now. Like, they're having some time together, and it's just like, I don't know, like... It's awkward. It's awkward right now.
Okay. Yeah. Sorry, Rocksteady. Yeah, I heard rumors, but whatever. Well, Raul, you have so many fans that love you, that are so happy that you came onto the show. What do you want to say to all of your fans?
I just want to thank you guys so much for watching and, you know, just having my back outside the house. And just, like, if people will say bad, because I've been reading, if people will say bad things, some of you guys will, like, talk and be like, oh, hell no, bro, it's like this. And I just want to thank you so much for that. You guys are amazing. You guys made my dream come true. Having you guys is just making my dream, my Mexican dream come true. Like, finally, I'm, like, famous, you know. I came out of, like, this little town. So I'm just so happy to have you guys. And I love you so much.
Tell the people where they can find you on social media, Raul, and we'll put the links below so that they can find you.
Perfect. So on Instagram, you can find me at THERAULYYC, because I'm from Calgary. And then on Twitter, you can find me at RAULBBCan. And on Snapchat is RAUL underscore. Underscore is a little line, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, the little line to MANRIQUEZ.
Well, if they're confused, just watch this back on our website, and right below, there'll be all the links to all of Raul's stuff. Well, Raul, you go and have an amazing, fun time at Beyonce. Whip your hair around for us.
Of course.
Okay, you're back.
Oh, that's true. That's true. Yeah. All right, Raul, we love you. Thank you so much for coming on and talking to everybody. Have fun at Beyonce.
Bye.
Bye, Raul.
Bye, love.
Okay, 1 second, Dana. Let me just, I gotta wait for, actually, I figured out the quick way to do this now. So everybody, let me tell you all this first. We have some other Big Brother Canada 4 announcements for all of you. Just let me fix Dana. And now I gotta fix me. Okay, so first, who is up next, Dana? On Sunday, we have the
Brothers. So excited.
Now, I'm also going to let you all in on a little secret. If you want to get your questions in, like, you know, a little bit earlier, you can hashtag them with YRR Live right now. Or you can still go to yourrealityrecaps.com/questions and put them in there. Those are two great ways to get all of your questions in and that we can see them. The chat freezes a lot for me. Like, there's so many of you in here. It's going so crazy. It freezes a lot for me. So that's
or it just flies. It's like, boom, yeah. It's gone.
Or it just flies and it's gone. So, I have the schedule right here. Why am I talking about it like I don't have it?
Oh,
here's
Monday
the schedule.
Cassandra.
Well, we're done with Raul. Tomorrow there is not going to be a show. I know for a fact I'm going to be too crazy with work. Sunday is Nick and Phil. Monday is Cassandra. And then Tuesday, if you missed it, it's official. Mitch will be here. And Mitch knows it's going to be a long show. Like, Raul, I knew his Beyonce concert was starting in, like, 15 or 20 minutes. So we knew we had to let him go. But don't worry. Cassandra's going to be a long show. The Brothers is going to be a long show. And,
can I just say thank you for booking them on days I don't have to work? Like, please, thank you.
Yes, they are going to be good. Eric, will Maddie and Ramsey be on at all? Guys, I'm trying. We're trying. You tweet them too. You guys, you know, Dana did an amazing blog post over at yourrealityrecaps.com/BBCan. Go check it out. She has everybody's Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, boogity boo. Click on those people and tell them, be like, when are you guys coming on Reality Recaps?
We've been working on them, but Maddie's still in Toronto with Ramsey, so they're out doing like touristy stuff every day.
Spreading butt cheeks. Ooh, maybe that's why they don't want to come on. Comedic recaps.
So, like, today they were at the zoo. They've been to Center Island. Like, they're just doing their thing and
spreading love. I want to remind you guys also, if you want to spread some love, consider becoming a patron. yourrealityrecaps.com/patron. It is what keeps us up and running all year. It's what's going to help us do everything that we want to do this summer for Big Brother 18. 24/7 live feed updates, recap shows, exit interviews, possibly even doing media day before the season and finale at the end of the season, but that would take a miracle of patrons. That's a lot of money and travel. Yeah. Dana, you look like a Disney princess tonight. A little Disney princess. Excellent transition. Yes, it is. Hi, Jersey girl. I didn't see you at all in the chat room, but my chat kept freezing and freezing. Question, is Nick allowed to talk on Sunday? I don't know. Look.
Except to Phil.
I don't know if people get that we do comedic recaps. And like I always say, I'm all for making all the jokes when they're in the house. But then once they're out of the house, I kind of like try and tone it down. However, on this schedule where I put most likely not doing a show, I legitimately was going to put out buying bananas. So, like, no show, out buying bananas. But I was like, I don't want to go that much.
You're so mean.
Oh, I'm going to tell him. I am going to tell him.
to say that those brothers are mighty fine huggers is all I have to say.
I can't wait. I can't wait for the brothers to come on. We're going to have
They're great huggers.
I'm excited that we had our very first live from a car, which, P.S., that had better audio than Joel from his house.
Or Nikki from the hotel.
So, future house guest, find out whatever data plan Raul has on his phone. And get that, because people in Canada, you have some shitty Wi-Fi. These are not our faults this time, this audio. But don't worry, New York City premiere party, we're going to have perfect audio. Are you going to call them Monkey and Girlface? Duh.
Yeah.
Not only am I going to call them Monkey and Girlface, well, I'm not going to call them it. I'm obviously going to call them Nick and Phil, but I'm going to show them the picture and explain why I dubbed them Monkey and Girlface. And then we're going to have a lot of fun and do comedic recaps. Sunday is going to be gold. It is. It's going to be so much fun. Raul is different to me outside the house.
They all are.
They all are. Mm-hmm. Everybody's different. It's a game. They're playing a game.
I find that I like some of the people that I hated most in the house, I actually like the best outside the house. So I always try not to be so cruel to them because I know once they get out of the house, they're different.
Yeah, I think they are too. And you're welcome, Rockstay. I am like selling my soul over here to get Kelsey for you. You're welcome. I'm putting people on the spot live to get you Kelsey.
We are trying. Her Twitter game isn't very great, so.
Kelsey and Jared are the only two people we're not in communication with trying to work it out. Well, and Tim, obviously.
I'm trying. I gotta get my kid. It's been so hot. I'm trying to get my kid in his onesie to, like, take a picture of it and, like, tweet him that. Mm-hmm. To, like, jog his memory, but it's been so hot. He won't put it on.
You make them put it on.
I'm trying.
There's no trying. You make them. You're the adult. You're the parent. They'll do it. He'll do it. He'll listen to you. Well, I think we sound better chat room. So let me do this. Chat room, you stay right there. Everybody else, if you're like, what are you talking about? We're talking about the You Now chat room, where you could be watching these shows live at 7 p.m. Eastern every night at urealityrecaps.com/YouNow. And the number one fan wins autographs. This show, it's Amber619. Congratulations, Amber. Go to urealityrecaps.com/prizes. To claim your prize. Thank you RJ Mitchell and Kayla and Jade Cap and Michelle B for also being top fans this show. Everybody else, if you're watching it back on our website, don't forget to comment below. If you're watching in YouTube, you can click on the buttons below Dana, thumbs up and subscribe, iTunes, 5-star rating and a nice review. You can see all of our content back at urealityrecaps.com/BBCanada.